एनीवे सो ब्रह्मण एव अनंतत्व प्राणस्य आनंद्यम आपेक्षिकम सो व्हेन प्राण इज सेड बी अनंत इन ए रिलेटिव सेंस धर्मिवत धर्मस्यापि तज्जन्यत्वात् तन्न अनुपत्ति इत्यर्थः सो धर्मिवत दैट ब्रह्म धर्मी एंड धर्मस्यापि तज्जन्यत्वात् सो वी कैन प्राण इज अ धर्म एंड ब्रह्म इज धर्मी सो ब्रह्म इज लिमिटलेस सो प्राण इज बोर्न ऑफ दैट यू कैन से दैट ऑल्सो इनहेरिट्स the quality of limitless, but in a secondary sense. Just as the creation is from Brahma, therefore creation should reflect the nature of Brahma. Brahma is satyam, jnanam, anantam. Therefore in the creation also we find asti, bhati, priyam in every nama and rupa. Although not in a primary sense that asti, bhati, priyam is not there where the nama rupa is, but then asti, bhati, priyam reflect the nama rupa. Nama rupa reflect asti, bhati, priyam. And so the prana reflects that anantyam in there, but we do find that anantyam in prana also, in that sense. So nowhere should ever your focus, attention be out of focus. That, you know, attention always focused upon Brahma, that it is anantam. Lest you believe that prana is ananta and start worshipping prana and forget Brahma, they are afraid, you know, that you might perhaps overdo this thing, you know. And therefore he never wants to leave this idea, this is ignorance, 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 all right. But anyway, asmin pakshe unipatah vikalpartha san na anantyavadyotiti akalaniyam. So asmin pakshe unipatah vikalpartha, who here means va, means shodhanada vikalpa, na anantya avadyoti, therefore, who is prakarantaradyoti, na anantyadyoti iti akalaniyam. That is how one should understand. Okay, now going back to Bhashya again. Nimittantarameva prashnapurvakam prakatayati. How prana is called sama, how that nimittantaram, another nimittam. So, prakarantaram prashnapurvakam prakatayati kena ityadina. Bhashyakara asks a question and explains how the Shruti shows equality in the prana, says Bhashya. केन पुनः प्रकारेण प्राणस्य तुल्यत्वम् इत्युच्यते तुल्यत्वम् सर्वसमत्वम् केन पुनः प्रकारेण बाय विच अदर वे यू कैन से दैट प्राणस्य तुल्यत्वम् और समत्वम् सो यदु एव समः तुल्यः इट इज सेड दैट इज प्राण इज समः तुल्यः In how do you say that? Prana is tulya. Sarva samatvam is equal to everything. How do you say that? Iti uchyate. Says Vashya, samah lushina puttika sharirena samo mashakena mashaka sharirena samo nagena hasti sharirena सम एभिस्त्रिभिर्लोकैः त्रैलोक्य शरीरेण प्राजापत्येन समः अनेन सर्वेण जगद्रूपेण हिरण्यगर्भेण समः कृष्णा Puttika sharirena. Puttika is here a small little bee or a white ant. So, samah plushina, footnote number 4, plushina iti. Ati sukshu sharirahi puttika plushirutyaje. So, what is this? This plushi. So, ati sukshu sharirahi puttika. Puttika means a bee. A very small bee, you know, is called plushihi. Plushihi utyaje. पुत्तिकादि शरीरेण समः प्राणः तदाश्रयात् पुत्तिकादि शरीरेण प्राणः समः सिंस प्राण इज टू बी फाउंड इन द शरीर ऑफ द बॉडी ऑफ द पुत्तिका और टू बी फाउंड एज द बॉडी ऑफ द पुत्तिका तदाश्रयात् तदाश्रयात् तत्र तत्र देहे समाप्य वृत्तेः इत्यर्थः द आइडिया इज दैट प्राण इज प्रेजेंट एज अ वेरी एसेंस ऑफ एवरीथिंग यू नो So in the puttika sharira, in the body of that little bee, masi, you know, something like that, that will fly around. That will be something like that is puttika. The small little creature, the smallest creature that you can imagine, I guess, you know. So that is puttika. So beginning from there. So there also prana is present totally. It's not that the prana, that Bhashyakara will explain, that a part of prana is present in puttika. It's not so. Prana is totally present in that one, and prana is totally present in everything. This is the whole idea here. Then alone you can say it's equal to puttika. If prana is divided into so many parts and one part is prana, then prana is not equal to that. That is only amsha. But here prana is to be equal to each one of them. Therefore, prana is totally present in all of them. This is the idea. Puttikata ati sukshmatama mashaka bhedaha. Some kind of little mosquito or some kind of a bee or whatever little creature is. So plushina puttika sharirena is equal to this body of this puttika or this little bee. White ant. Samo mashakena mashaka sharirena is also equal to the body of a mosquito. Samo nagena, naga means elephant. Hasti sharirena is also equal to the body of an elephant. Samaha ebihi tribhirlokaihi is also equal to these three worlds. Means what? Trailokya sharirena prajapatyena is equal to this whole three worlds, meaning the body that is represented by three worlds, meaning he is equal to the prajapati. Prajapatyena. Trailokyatmaka virat sharirena ityardha equal to virat. For whom the three worlds are the body, that is a virat, he is equal to virat. Samaha anena sarvena, one word sarvena should be added from the shruti. Samaha anena sarvena is equal to all of this. Hiranyagarbhena. So he is equal to the Hiranya, body of the Hiranyagarbha. Says footnote number 7. So anena is sarvena, that's how it is explained, or anena sarvena should be added. Hiranyagarbhena idi nanu prana nam, very interesting questions, you know. You say prana is equal to Hiranyagarbha, both are the same. Prana is Hiranyagarbha, how can Hiranyagarbha is equal to Hiranyagarbha? So you have to give some answer anyway. And so nanu prana nam sutratma, because we say prana means wherever Shruti uses prana, we have to call it that way. Which is okay, but then says prana nam sutratma. Tasya teineva samyam katham prana himself is Hiranyagarbha. How do you say that prana is Hiranyagarbha? Because Hiranyagarbha cannot be said to be Hiranyagarbha. Ida ashankya samahedam vartika. I am just reading how these questions are raised, you know, little subtle questions. And then samadhanam and also explanations are given there. Tatha Hiranyagarbhena lingatma samayevatu. So this lingatma is equal to the body of the Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyagarbha is body of the Hiranyagarbha. Kriya Shaktimadha Jnana Shaktimadha Samyamidhi Bhavaha. So therefore, this Kriya Shaktimadha, this prana who is Kriya Shaktiman, Jnana Shaktimadha Samyam, then Hiranyagarbha is understood as Jnana Shaktiman, and so both are equal because Ubhay Shaktiatma Hisaha, prana is both possessed of the Kriya Shakti and Jnana Shakti. Therefore, say that prana possessed of jnana shakti is equal to prana possessed of kriya shakti. In this way you can say. Okay, now go to Anandagiri. Nanu pranasya tattat sharira parinamatve parichinnatvat. If you say that the prana has transformed himself into all this body, like the gold transforms itself into all these ornaments, and similarly also prana has transformed himself into all these bodies, then tattat sharira parinamatve parichinnatva, in that case he has become limited because he has transformed himself into all these little things. Anantya anupattihi, in that case prana cannot be limitless. Tat kathamasya viruddeshu shariresu samatva iti asankyaha. If prana is not ananta or without limit, then how can prana be equal to a mosquito on one hand, an elephant on the other hand, and virat on the third hand? How can one thing be equal to all? This question is, how can one prana, he can be equal to Hiranyagarbha? He cannot be equal to mashaka or a mosquito. How can he be simultaneously equal to all of them? This is the question. It's not that he is only present in all of them. He says, Samaha Mashaket Plushina. He is equal to all of them. Not only present in all of them, equal to all of them. How can one entity be equal to all of them unless that entity has transformed itself and therefore lost its anandyam? So Vashyakara says, Puttikadi Sharireshu Gotvadivata Kartsnena Parisamapta Iti Samatvam Pranasya Napunah Sharira Matra Pariname Naiva Amurtatvat Sarvagatatvacha. Puttikadi Sharireshu Gotvadivat Karsnena Parisamaptaha. What this means is, if you go to page 134, then see Anandagiri on the first line. Khandadishu Gotvat Sharireshu Sarvatya Sarvatra Sthirasya Pranasya. Like Khandadishu. So when there is a cow, all the Gotva or the cowness is present in all the cows, this idea. So khanda means the cow which is lame, you know, devoid of one limb. Or munda means the cow without, the horns. So in all such cows also the gotva. Gotva means the cowness is equally present in all of them. It is not that because the cow is small that the cowness is small. Or the cow is large that the cowness is large. How cowness is equally present in all of them. So this is how, it doesn't matter how the cow is. A cow may be defective, cow may be lame, cow may be big, cow may be small, whatever it is. But how cowness is equally present in all of them. In that manner, sarvatra sthitasya pranasya. Prana is in that manner present as the essence of everything. In that sense, it is equally present in all of them. This is the idea. So Vashyakara said then, Uttikadi Sharireshu Gotvadivata. Just as Gotvam, the cowness, is present in its totality in every cow, Karsnena Parisamaptaha. The prana is, so just as cowness is totally present in every cow, big or small, and so also prana is equally present in all these bodies. Parisamapta Vyaptaha. Kasnena sarva avachedena. So, just as the cowness is present in the cow entirely, and so also the prana is present in all the bodies entirely, iti samatvam prana, iti hetoho. Because of this reason we say that prana is samaha, tulya. This is Anandagiri. Samashabdasya yathashrutarthatvam kimnasyat. Yathashrutarthatvam means parinama matra rupatvam. Why can't we say that sama here means? No. Tattasharya. Tatchacharya parinamatva rupam. That the prana has actually transformed himself into all these bodies. Why not we understand it that way? So Vashyakara. Iti ashaya na punaha. Vashyakara na punaha. Sharira matra parinama naiva. That merely being transformed into a body, in that manner, prana, the equality of prana is not stated here. Amurtatvat sarvagatatvat cha. Prana is amurta. Prana is without any murta, without any form. Sarvagatatvat cha. He is all pervasive. And therefore, he cannot be confined to any given body, etc. He being all pervasive. Therefore, he is equally present as a very life force. He is the very essence of the very vitality. So prana is not an entity in that sense, like gold or something, tangible. That is what is meant by amurtam. Amurtam means it is not gross. It is a subtle concept. This is what we call vitality. So prana is a very vitality, and therefore as vitality, he is present equally in all the bodies. Therefore every body possesses vitality, and that is how amurtatvat sarvagatatvat cha. He is amurta, meaning he is formless. and is all pervasive. Adidaivikena rupena amutatvam sarvagatatvam cha drashtavyam. Since adidaivika prana is not individual prana, but adidaivika prana, and therefore amurta and sarvagata. See, when prana comes to one particular body, then he attains a certain form and he becomes limited also. So the prana that we are talking about is not the one that is just transformed in one body. The prana that is the total prana, which appears in every body as the very breath and sustaining the life and the vitality. Then Anandagiri says, Nanu pradipo ghate sankuchati prasade cha vikasati tatha pranopi mashakadi shariresu sankocham ibhadi deheshu vikasam va apadyatamiti. So why not we put it this way? Yatha nanu pradipa, imagine a lamp. If you place a lamp in a small little enclosure like a pot, then the light of the lamp, it fills up the pot space. If the very same lamp is placed in a room or in a hall, the light of the lamp will fill up that very hall. So how the light, it goes through what we call sankocha and vikasa. It gets contracts according to the enclosure, and again it expands according to the bigger enclosure. So why not we say that prana contracts in the mashaka sharira and the prana expands in the elephant body, etc. Iti samatva asiddhi. Ekarasatva asiddhi. In that case, the intensity of the prana will be less and more. You see, the same lamp in a pot will be much more, intense. Light would be, light intensity will be more. Same lamp placed in a big hole, the intensity of light will be less. In that case, ekarasattvam, or the equality of intensity, is not there. So prana expands in an elephant, then he will be less, intense in elephant. And if it is, he is there totally in a mashaka, in that case it will be more intense and stuff like that, then equality is not there again. That is samatva asiddhiti asangyaha nachaiti, says Bhashyakara. I mean, how much you can think about every little thing, that's the idea here. So that is see, when we study, we have to study everything, and at least we have to see how the ancient people thought about this. How much attention they pay to every little thing, and they did not take anything, it's easy, and so we are satisfied. But when you start meditating, then you realize that you have to clear all these points. For us, we have to go through these passages, is okay. And then we study as an academic interest, and how nice it is to know that we study Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, and so on and so forth. But those who want to do what it is, then they have to clarify how is he equal, in what manner is he equal? Is he equal that he is present in these pockets? Is he equal that he expanded and filled up that space? In what manner is he equal? So when you want to meditate upon equality, because then alone you can become the Hiranyagarbha. So that is Sayujyam you want to attain, suppose, or Salokadam. In that case, you have to really meditate upon that equality. If that equality is not clear in your mind, how are you going to meditate upon that? So merely by using word equal, your mind is not able to visualize that. So upasana requires visualization, and visualization requires a clarity. Therefore, the discussion here about the clarity, what is the manner of this samatvam? So Vashyakara says, nacha ghataprasadadi pradipavata संकोच विकासितया शरीरेषु तावन् मात्रं समत्वम् तावन् मात्रं परिणाम मात्र रूपं समत्वम् इज नॉट दैट द प्राण एक्सपैंड एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स एटसेट्रा इन दैट मैनर ही फिल्स अप दोज बॉडीज एंड दैट इज हाउ प्राण इज इक्वली प्रेजेंट इन ऑल ऑफ देम बट ही इज इक्वल इन ऑल ऑफ देम दैट इज ऑल इन दिस दैट एक रस इक्वल ही इज इन ऑल ऑफ देम Pranasya sarvagatatve samatva shruti virodham asankhyaha. If the prana is all pervasive, then that seems to contradict this shruti. So, we have to read this sentence here. Taete sarve eva samaha sarve anantaha iti shrutehe. So Brihadaranyaka itself says in these the fifth Brahmana, te ete, this is footnote number 12, page 133. It is sarve vagadaya samaha tulyaha. All these vaga, not only prana, means all these devatas are equal. Kena rupena iti akankshama sarve anantaha iti. All these devatas are anantaha, and therefore they are equal. This is what Brihadaranyaka itself is going to say. Therefore says, pranasya sarvagatatve samatpasruti virodhamasankhyaha. Then if prana is sama, then this sarvagata shruti is contradicted. So bhashyakare sarvagatasya iti. Sarvagatasya tu shareeresho sharira parinama vrittilabha na viruddhyate sarvagatasya tu. So, the one who is sarvagata, meaning all pervasive, shareeresu, in the different bodies, shareera parimana vrittilava, not parinama, parimana. The shareera parimana vritti, that is equal to this body, parimana vrittilava na viruddhyate. That one that is all pervasive can be of the size of the body, that is not na viruddhyate. So, it is not that it is. So everywhere it is parimana actually, not parinama, that's right. Okay. Parimana matra rupam. So how the one who is all pervasive can be equal to a body, that is what we just read here, khandadishu, gotvavat, just as the gotva is present in every cow, equally present. So whether the big cow or small cow does not make the cowness small or big, and so also whether the body is big or small does not make that prana's presence small or big. In that manner, prana can be equally present in all the bodies, even though he is all pervasive. Tattat sharira parimanayaha vrittehe labha sambhavati. Therefore, vritte means sarupasya. Therefore, one that can be gotvam can be present in every size. Sarvagatasya vanavasaha tatra tatra kupakumbhadi avachedopulambhadi ityardaha. So again, Nabha, which is all pervasive, how that all pervasive, this space. So whether it is a part space or room space or whatever space, that spaceness is equally present in part space or room space. It's not that space gets divided in that sense, although it appears to assume the size of every enclosure or container, still the space doesn't get divided, the spaceness does not get divided. That accommodation, that the quality of the space doesn't get divided, and so also the prana, which is vitality, doesn't get divided when he is equally present in all the bodies. So that is how the samatvam or equality is there. Phalashrutim avatarya vyakaroti. Then, so here now the phalashruti is being explained. This is Vashakara. Evam samatva. Samakhyam pranam vedayah shruti prakashita mahatvam tasya etat phalam ashnude vyapnodi samnah pranasya sayujyam sayubhavam samana dehendriyabhimanatvam salokyam samana lokatamva bhavana visheshatah evam etadyathoktam samapranam veda. Evam samatva, in this manner, since prana is equal, meaning equally present or equal to all the bodies, because prana is equally present in all of them. Samakhyam pranam yaha veda. So one who meditates upon prana, who is called sama, shruti prakashita mahatvam, whose mahatvam, the greatness, is something that is revealed by the shruti. Tasya etat phalam, for the upasaka, this is the result. Ashnude vyapnodi samna pranasya sayujyam. One attains the sayujyam or oneness, you know, the merger into the prana. Samana dehendriya abhimanatvam. Prana is actually Hiranyagarbha, meaning identified with the totality of all the subtle bodies, and so also the upasaka attains that kind of identification. So prana also has a body, and therefore he also becomes part of that body or merges into that body. So he also has the same abhimana of the same body. This is the kind of the mukti that we talk about, you know. So salokyam or samipyam, sarupyam, sayujyam, etc. Salokyam samana lokatam va. If the word prana is interpreted as Vishnu or Shiva or something, then this would mean sayujyam, then being total merging into Lord Vishnu or Shiva. Or samana lokatam va salokyam. Or one attains the place in the same loka or the same world like Vaikuntha or Kailasa, so you remain, you attain the same loka. Why these two kinds of results? Bhavana visheshataha upasti vailakshanya, depending upon the intensity of the meditation. So salokatam is less intense and sayujya is the most intense meditation, identification. Evametad yathoktam sama pranam vedavan, who meditates upon the prana, which is sama, in this manner. So phala vikalpa hetu maha. Why the two vikalpas are given? Because bhavana visheshatah. Vedanam vyakarati. What do you mean by knowing the prana? Says Vashyakara. Apranatma abhimana अभिव्यक्ते उपास्ते उपास्ते इत्यर्थः. उपास्ते उपास आ प्राणात्मा अभिमान अभिव्यक्ते. सो दिस उपास्ति मीन्स उपासना is what? Aap pranatma abhiman abhivyakte hai. So, abhivyakte hai upaste ityartha hai. So, one meditates until, so upaste means he meditates. Up to what? Pranatma abhiman abhivyakte hai. Up to, means up to the point, up to the abhivyakti or the manifestation of a total identification with prana. So, pranatma, one that totally identifies with the prana, up to that, the abhimana identification manifests. Until then, this upasana is carried out, and then this is the result that comes. That's the idea. Idam cha phalam madhya pradipanyayana ubhayadah sambandham ita avadeyam. This phala is to be connected with the mantras that have gone by and the mantra that is going to follow. So this section consisting of four mantras represents one upasana. And this is the result that is to be applicable to both. So even though the result of the upasana should come at the end, here it seems to come in the middle. So madhya pradipanayana, like the dehali, the one, the lamp that is in the middle, illumines both. So this result also should illumine both the upasana mentioned in both the mantras. Okay, now we continue the other one, the next mantra. सिद्धानगिरी प्रस्तावादि शब्दवत् उद्गीत शब्दस्यापि भक्ति विशेषे रूढत्वात् उद्गीतेन अत्ययाम इत्यत्र च औद्गात्रे कर्मणि प्रयुक्तत्वात् कथम उद्गीतः प्राण इति आशंक्याः. प्रस्तावादि शब्दवत् उद्गीत शब्दस्यापि सेज फुटनोट वसम आदिना छंदोग्योक्ता हिंकारादयो ग्राह्यः. सो छंदोग्य उपनिषद सेड दैट the Sama Mantra has these five stages, five divisions or five stages. Hinkara, Prastava, Udgita, Pratihara, Nidhanam. So, this is how the five stages are there. You start with Hinkara and then Prastava. Then Udgita represents its climax or climax. Pratihara and then Nidhanam. So, these are said to be the five stages of the recital of the Sama Mantra. And there are seven stages also in that case called Sapta Bhaktika. This is called Pancha Bhaktika Sama Mantra. So Himkara Prastava. Then Prastava is one stage or one part of Sama Mantra, you know. So there also we find hinkara prasthava udgita pratihara nidanam. So prasthava udgita, all of these are different bhakta means different parts of sama mantra. So Ananda gives prasthava adivata. Like prasthava, hinkara, etc. are the divisions of a sama mantra. Udgita shabdasyavi bhakti visheshe rudatvat. So what Udgita is also Ruda is well known as one of the Anga of or one of the part of the Sama Mantra. And also Udgita in Atyayameti. In the first mantra of this one here, so Dvayaha Prajapatyaha, that the Devata said Udgita in Atyayameti, that we will conquer these Asuras by the recital of the Udgita. So there the Udgita was employed in the sense of recital. Audgatre karmani prayuktatvar. So Udgata is the chanter of the Sama Mantra. Audgatre karma means the recital performed by that priest. So there the word Udgita was used in the sense of recital. And generally the Udgita is one of the Anga or one of the limbs of that Sama Mantra. So in which way then? Katham Udgita pranaha. Which way do you say that? Prana Udgita Asankya Udgita Namaiti. So now we go to the next mantra where the prana is equated Udgita. And what should the meaning of Udgita there? Whether Udgita should mean that one portion of the Sama Mantra or Udgita should mean that karma of the recital. In which way prana is said to be Udgita? Okay, so we read the 23rd mantra. एषौ वै उद्गीतः प्राणो वा उत प्राणेन हि इदं सर्वं उत्तब्धं वागेव गीता उच्च गीता च इति सौद्गीतः. सो अनदर वेरी unique explanation of the word Udgita, and also to say that this is the primary meaning of the word Udgita. The Udgita is now made up of two elements, Ud and Gita. So Ud is Prana and Gita or Gita, making it feminine because Vag is feminine. So Gita, which is said to be derived from the root Gai in the sense of singing, so Gita is song, and so that is equated to Vag. And Ut, as the Shruti explains, so prana va Ut, Ut is prana. Why this so? Prana nahi idam sarvam uttabdham. All of this is held, you know, uttabdham. Held high or held aloft. Everything is held in that position by prana. Therefore, prana is called Ut. Uttabdham. So there also Ut means, so in terms of Ut plus Tha. So there which is, you know, held up. Therefore, Vashyakara will explain that this prefix ut here, or the particle ut, is in the sense of holding something above. So prana holds everything in their place. Therefore, prana is called ut. And vageva gita. Since all the songs, etc. are performed by the vagindriya, therefore we say that, or singing also is a part of speech, therefore we say that speech is in fact gita. Uccha Gita cha iti Udgita. That is Ut, and that which is Gita is called Udgita. So that's another interesting derivation. Everywhere we are seeing, you know, beginning with Ashwamedha, right up to Sama, and here also Udgita. Alright, so going back to Bhashya now. Esho va Udgita. Esha means prana. This prana is indeed, because he is the subject matter under discussion, therefore the pronoun esha or this can be used for that. This prana is Udgita, indeed. Then the question is, what should be the meaning of word Udgita? Should it mean one limb of the Sama Mantra, or should it mean that Udgana karma? So Vashyakara says, Udgito nama Sama avayavaha भक्ति विशेष है न उद्गानम स सामाधिकारात्। उद्गीतो नाम साम अवयवः। सो हियर द वर्ड उद्गीत शुड मीन अवयव और वन लिंब ऑफ द साम मंत्र। भक्ति विशेष है विच इज वन। भक्ति मीन्स भाग, मीन्स वन पोर्शन ऑफ साम। दिस इज वॉट इट शुड मीन हियर। न उद्गानम, बट देन इट शुड नॉट मीन उद्गानम और द एक्ट ऑफ सिंगिंग। दैट इज नॉट वॉट इज मेंट बाय उद्गीत। बाय उद्गीत इज मेंट वन पार्ट ऑफ साम। व्हाई इज इट सो? साम अधिकारात्। Because here the context is Sama. Because the earlier mantra also talked about Sama, and that being the context here, therefore Udgita, Sama there is Sama, and Sama there does not mean just a singing. Sama is Prana actually. So Sama Adhikara means Prana Adhikara. Since the Adhikara or the context is of Prana, that's what it says here. Sama Shabdidasya Pranasya Prakritatvad Hetumaha Sama Adhikara. That Sam means Prana, so prana, discussion is pertaining to Prana and not of singing or some kind of a Kriya. Therefore here Udgita should mean that limb or avayava of that Sama, Sama Mantra. The Anandagiri continues, Natavat Udgita Shabdasya Prana Rudhihi. But nobody knows this Udgita as Prana. So Rudhi means a common use. So this word Udgita is never used commonly in the sense of prana. Tasmin vruddha prayoga adashanat. Vruddha prayoga means that is called rudhi. That the ancients or the learned people, when they use a given word in a given sense, then it becomes prachalita. So that's how very many new words also become slowly common to us. When some learned people use it again and again and again, and then they become the common thing. But in that manner, the word Udgita has never been used in the sense of prana by the people who are learned. Napi yoga hai, nor in any derivative sense can the word Udgita mean prana, you know. Avayava vrittehe adrishtehe. We don't find avayava vrittehe adrishtehe apratitehe. We don't find this, the avayava of Udgita actually meaning prana. We don't see it. So Shruti has to show us. Iti Shankare Kathamiti. Says Vashya, Katham Udgitav Pranaha Prano Va Uta Pranenahi Yasmad Idam Sarvam Jagata Uttabdham Urdhvam Stabdham Uttam Vitam Vidrutam Ityarthah Uttabdharthavadyotakah Ayam Ut Shabdah Prana Guna Vidhayakah. Katham Udgita Prana. How do you say that? Prana is Udgita. So yoga vrittim upetya pariharati. By yoga vritti in a derivative sense, so the avayava or the parts of your Udgita, then they actually convey the meaning prana. So word Udgita in a common, the way it is commonly used, does not convey prana, but the parts of which the word Udgita is made, they convey the meaning prana. That is called yoga vritti. So derivative meaning. Or more than derivative meaning, also derivative meaning of the limbs, you know, they amount to this. So sama, so sa and ama is not a derivative meaning, but then that's how you can imagine, because what is saman actually? But anyway, so sama is taken as sa and ama, and so in that manner you can say that the avayava of this word Udgita, they actually convey the meaning of prana. Herself is pranava uta. That prana is indeed uta. So prasiddhi. Pranayahi, because yasmad idam sarvam jagat uttabdham urdhvam stabdham uttam vitam vidhutam ityardaha. Because it's well known that it is prana that holds aloft the whole creation. Because sun and the moon and all of them are in that position, because prana actually holds them in that position. So the whole creation is held in its position because of prana. This is something that is well known. That's why prana is called sutra. Just a sutra or a thread holds all the flowers, you know, or the pearls in their in a harmony, in a garland. And so also the sutratma prana holds the entire creation in its place. If that sutra is not there, how all the pearls would scatter away, and so the whole creation would scatter away if prana were not supporting them. That is called sutratma. In that sense, we say that the prana holds the entire creation aloft in its position. Utshabdha nasya arthasya vachaka nipadatvadi ashankya. Just a question. That word ut is a particle, then how does he convey this meaning? Ut means above, actually. It is a common meaning also. Ut means above. And so to hold above also. So uttabdhaarthavadyotakah ayam utshabdha. This utshabdha is uttabdhaarthavadyotakah, that which reveals the meaning of holding aloft. That is what the word ut means here. Nipatana manekarthatvad. Okay. That's interesting. Read footnote number 1 now. Pranava uditi taduktam vartike. See what the vartikara has to say. Upasarga udityesha sachanam sachatyanta kriyashitah sanyojya kriyayatastam vyatashte shruti ranjasa. Upasarga ut iti esha upasarga. Ut iti upasarga. This upasarga is a prefix. Such a atyanta kriyashritaha, when it is joined totally with the kriya, sanyojya, so kriyashritaha iti, utkrushta kriya, atyanta kriyashritaha, utkrushta kriya vachaka. Ut means above or utkrushta, something that is exalted. So the particle ut, which is used as a prefix, then it can be used as a prefix before verbs and nouns and whatever. So ut, which is used as a prefix, it indicates something that utkrushtam, something that is exalted. Utkrushta kriyavachakah, it indicates something that an exalted kriya or an exalted activity is what is actually indicated by this particle ut. Utkarsha vachakah iti yavat, exaltedness is what is indicated by this word ut. Tat kriyaya sanyojya. So utkarsha vachakatvam tasya manasi kritva tat kriya sanyojya. So connecting that with actually kriya, meaning what? Utkarsha vachakatvam tasya manasi kritva. Keeping in mind the fact that the particle ut actually imparts an exaltedness to wherever it is connected. Sarvottambhakatvam tasya brute ityardha. Then Shruti says sarvam uttabdham. And therefore, keeping in mind the fact that wherever the ut particle is connected, it imparts an exaltedness to that thing. So therefore, ut is in the sense of exaltedness, and that exaltedness above, and then in that sense, the Shruti says that the prana holds everything, therefore ut is prana, because prana also holds everything above, and ut also is that which brings about utkarsha, or an ascension of wherever it is there. So Shruti Ranjasa, Anjasa Sakshat, Shruti Vyachaste. Shruti herself says, Pranayana Idam Sarvam Uttabdham. Then footnote number 2. Sarvam Jagad Uttabdham Iti Atra Vartikam. Uttabdham Vidhrutam Yasmat Pranayana Jagaditvaram Ut Pranavatav Prasiddhastu Gunadud Gita Uchyade Iti. Uttabdham Vidhrutam Yasmat Pranayana Jagaditvaram. This itvaram jagat, nashashilam jagat, since it is held by prana, since by prana this whole creation which is vinashashila, meaning which is perishable, is held in its position. Ataha prana ut, therefore prana is ut, prasiddha. Prasiddhastu gunad udgitha. Even though the word udgitha is prasiddha, in the sense of either a limb of the prana, sama mantra, that prasiddhi is only in a secondary sense. In the primary sense, udgita should mean prana. Prasiddha samabhakti visheshah gunat aropat. prana nirvartitvat. So that sama avayava is called udgita only because we superimpose an aspect upon that limb, because it is something that is accomplished by prana. Therefore, since prana is involved, it is connected with prana in as much as udgita meaning that chanting, or udgita also means that particular limb. Since that can be accomplished only by prana, in that sense it is connected to prana. Therefore, in the secondary sense, udgita is so called, but in primary sense, udgita should mean prana. So, prana is called udgita in that sense, but prana is called udgita in this, in the primary sense. So, prana guna vidhayakaha, Vashyakara said, Uttambaram prana gunaha, therefore Utshabda is prana guna vidhayakaha. So that Utshabda actually indicates this Uttambaram or holding aloft, which is the guna of the prana, that is what is actually here stated or indicated by the word Ut. Tasmat Ut pranaha, therefore Ut. Says pranasya utshabdatve bhi gita shabdatva bhavat. But we are talking about the whole udgita. You say that prana is ut, but prana is not gita. Then how do you say prana is udgita? Katam udgita daiti ashanke gita shabdarthamaha. So now the Shruti herself gives the meaning of the word gita. Says there in the Bhashya.
Vageva Gita Shabda Visheshatvat Udgita Bhaktehe.
Vageva Gita. Alright, so this Gita means Vag. Shabda Visheshatvat Udgita Bhaktehe. Udgita Bhaktehe Shabda Visheshatvat. सा उद्गीत भक्ति ही गीयते अनया यदि व्युत्पत्ति है गीत शब्दार्थ वागेव इत्यर्थ. सो उद्गीत भक्ति ही उद्गीत गीयते अनया यदि व्युत्पत्ति है इज हाउ वर्ड गीत इज सेड टू बी डिराइव्ड. गीयते अनया दैट बाय विच समथिंग इज संग. सो उद्गीत इज दैट बाय विच दिस संग समथिंग इज संग. इन दैट सेंस यू कैन से दैट विच इज समथिंग इज संग एंड दैट इज व्हाट एवर संग इज बाय ओनली स्पीच. इन दैट सेंस दिस स्पीच इज सेड टू बी गीता. So, Shabda Visheshatvat Udgita Bhaktehe is nothing not different from a Shabda or a sound also, and therefore it is speech only. It is a modification of speech. What we call Udgita is nothing but modification of speech, and therefore it can be equated to speech. Says Vashyakara, can it further?
गायते शब्दार्थत्वात् सावागेव नहि उद्गीत भक्तेः शब्दव्यतिरेकेण किञ्चित् रूपम् उपलभ्यते तस्मात् युक्तम् अवधारणम् वागेव गीठेति.
गायते हे शब्दार्थत्वा सिस फुटनोट नंबर 8 गायते हे दी गीयते अनयादि व्युत्पत्ते हे गीता वाग इत्यर्थ है. सो स्पीच इज दैट बाय विच यू सिंग समथिंग दैट आल्सो. सो स्पीच इज दैट बाय विच यू सिंग समथिंग देयरफॉर गीयते अनयादि गीता एंड सो दैट स्पीच इज दैट बाय विच यू सिंग देयरफॉर स्पीच इज कॉल्ड गीता. दैट इज हाउ वी कैन से गायते हे शब्दार्थत्वात् सा वागेव देयरफॉर गीता इज वाग एव नहीं उद्गीत भक्ते शब्द व्यतिरेकेण किंचित रूपम उपलभ्यते. व्हाट वी कॉल उद्गीत इज नथिंग अदर देन अ साउंड और नथिंग अदर देन यू नो सो अ साउंड एंड देयरफॉर उद्गीत इज नथिंग एंड देयरफॉर इज नथिंग बट द स्पीच. तस्माद् युक्तम उदाहरणम वाग एव गीता इति. सो इट इज क्वाइट प्रॉपर टू एम्फसाइज और असर्टेन दैट वाग एव गीता. व्हाट इज कॉल्ड वाग इज इंडीड गीता. ओके तथापि कथम प्राणस्य उद्गीतत्वम. ऑल राइट देन आल्सो हाउ डू यू से दैट प्राण इज उद्गीत. उद इज प्राण एंड गीता इज वाक. So how does a prana is udgita? So vag upasarjanasya tasya tathatvam kathayati. That prana of which vag is secondary. So prana along with vag, where vag enjoys a secondary place, so he is called udgita. So that's what Bhashya says.
Uccha prana gita cha prana tantra va iti ubhayam ekena shabdena abhidhiyate sa udgita.
Uccha prana, what you call ut is prana, gita cha vag, and gita cha prana tantra vag, and gita is vag, which is prana tantra, means totally derived from prana. It is ubhayam ekena shabdena abhidhiyate, prana and vag, in as much as vag is not separate from prana, vag is nothing but a modification or manifestation of prana, in that sense udgita can be said to be prana. Sa udgita. Okay. Now, going to page 136, Anandagiri says, introducing the next mantra, Taddhapi ityadi vakyase prakrita anupayogam ashankya aha. What does the next statement, next passage have to do with this? So, all whatever has to be stated about upasana is stated. Taddhapi, that's the next mantra, beginning from there, ityadi vakyase prakrita anupayogam. Prakrita is what? Udgita devatayam prane prakrita anupakarakatvam. So prakrita anupayogam udgita devatayam prane prakrite. That prana is udgita, that is what is being said. Or udgita is possible because of prana, that also is meant. Udgita is possible because of prana, that is what has been said. What is the relevance that the next passage has with reference to this topic under discussion? Where the topic under discussion is that the prana is that with udgita upakaraka. Prana is that which brings about the udgita, because of prana the udgita is. In what manner the next passage contribute to this idea? So Vashyakara says, that's the last sentence on the page 135.
Uktasadardhyaya akhyayika arabhyate.
Uktasadardhyaya. What is uktartha? Udgita devata prana hai, na vagadhiti uktartha hai. So udgita devata, this devata udgita is prana alone, and not vagadhi. Don't think that the udgita is actually accomplished by vagadhi devata. Udgita is that which is accomplished by prana devata. That's the udgita is something that is accomplished by prana devata and not by other devata such as vag. Because they are also called prana in a secondary sense, but mukhya prana is the devata of udgita. Because prana udgita, that's what is said, and says that the next passage, in the form of a story, confirms that very, or ascertains that very same point. Says the mantra 24.
Taddhapi brahmadattaha चैकितानेयः राजानं भक्षयन् उवाच अयन्तु अस्य राजा मूर्धान् विपातयतात् यत इतः अयास्यः आङ्गिरसः अन्येन उद्गायत अन्येन उद्गायत इति वाचा च ह्येव सप्राणेन च उद्गायदिति
तत्ह अपि तद्धापि. That means tasmin arthe ukte arthe. In what has been said so far in this earlier passage, here is also this story. What is story? Brahmadatta, Chaikitaneya. Brahmadatta who is the great grandson of Chikitana. So Chikitana and then Chekitana, Chekitaneyaha. So great grandson of Chikitana who is called Brahmadatta. He must be some very great person apparently, because in a sabha he makes this, declares this. You know, to say this requires a lot of confidence and a lot of strength. Rajanam Bhakshayan, Raja, he means Soma. So in a given sabha must be there, the priest, this fellow is drinking Soma. Drinking means not drinking. They must perform a yaga, Soma yaga. As a result of performance of the yaga, you get that prasada, which is what the Brahmins or the priests, you know, partake. That's what he must have been doing. Not that he was a drunkard or something like that. But then, so that's why, Trailokya, Somapa, what is it? Somapaha, Pudapapaha. That's how Lord Krishna says, Somapaha means those people who drink a lot of Soma. Means those people who perform many Soma yagas. So maybe having performed the Soma yaga, then the pandits discuss. And therefore he must be also saying something very confidently. Rajanam Bhakshayan, meaning drinking the Soma. Uvacha, this Brahmadatta said, Ayam Tosya Raja, this Soma Raja. So Soma is called Raja. Soma Raja, the Chandra also is nothing but the embodiment of Soma, so he is also Raja. So the people who go there attain that kind of body and also gain those kind of pleasures. Asya Raja Murdhanam Vipatayatat. This Raja Soma Raja may actually cut off my head, he says, you know. Ita yad yad. If itaha ayasyangirasaha. This ayasyangirasaha is a person. So ayasyangirasaha itaha anyena udgayadidi. If this priest whose name was Ayasyangirasa, if he chanted this Udgita, he sang the Udgita by something other than this prana, then my head would drop off. Meaning that whoever recites Udgita must recite only through prana. It is because of prana that one is able to recite Udgita and by nothing else. If this person was able to recite Udgita by means other than prana, then my head may be chopped off, he says, you know. Iti, this is what he said. That's all. This is a story. So what do you understand from this story? So Shruti says, Vacha, Vacha, Chakheva, Sab Pranayana, Cha Udgayata Iti. So when he says it so confidently, means what? That this Ayasyangirasa, he recited the Udgita by Prana. Otherwise he would not say confidently that if he recited it by something other than prana, then my head will be chopped off. Nobody would say that. And his head did not get dropped off. That means he was right. Meaning that this Ayasya Angirasa recited the Udgita only with prana. So wherever Udgita is recited, or wherever Udgita is, prana is definitely there. So prana is the devata of Udgita. Don't think that is Vagindriya that recites. Yes, Vagindriya is there. But Vachacha, Vagindriya only is supported by prana. And prana, which is the principle, that is how the recital of Udgita is possible. So this story tells us that prana is the devata of Udgita and not some other devata. Therefore, prana is Udgita. This is how the Udgita of the prana is here. Verified or confirmed by this, with the help of the story. It's an Upanishadic way, you know. And so, that's how you teach children, but through stories and things like that, you think. Maharsha explains, Taddhabe Tata Tatra Etasmin Mukte Arthe Api Akshay Kabi Shruyate Hasma Tad Ha Api. Tat means Tatra, with reference, means what? Tatra means Etas, Tatra means with there, meaning what? Etasmin, with reference to this, meaning what? Ukte Arthe, with reference to this Artha, or what has been stated in the previous passage. Ha shows itihas, something that happened. Ha api akshayika api shruyate hasma. That is akshayika also is shruyate. Is something that is well known among certain circles. So what is akshayika? Says Vashyakara.
ब्रह्मदत्तो नामतः चिकितानस्य अपत्यं चैकितानः तदपत्यं युवा चैकितानेयः राजानं यज्ञे सोमं भक्षयन् उवाच
So Brahmadatta namataha, his name was Brahmadatta. Chikitanasya apatyam, Chaikitanaha. So the son or progeny of Chikitana is called Chaikitana. Tad apatyam yuva. Jivati tu vamshe yuva iti smranad. Pitradu vamshe jivati. Pautra prahurtehe yad apatyam. Tad yuva sanyakam iti drashtavyam. So a particular apatya or particular progeny gets a sanya yuva. When? Pitrado Vamshe Jivati, when his grandfather or great grandfather is alive, then this fellow gets a particular sanya. So when he is born, his great grandfather is alive, then he gets a particular kind of name. So shows that his great grandfather was alive or is alive, that's how you understand from his very name, you see. Cannot be alive for the whole life, but at least he was alive when this fellow was born, you know. And so, Pautra Prahutehe Yadapatyam, up to Pautra. That apatyam. So this Chaikitana, this is the putra of Chaikitana, not putra of Chaikitana. So what we call this Chaikitaneya is a putra of Chaikitana. So Chaikitana must be alive when he was born, therefore it's called Chaikitaneya. Tad yuva sanyakam iti drashtavyam. Okay. So the name is explained here. So Chaikitaneya Rajanam Yajne. So Vishvasrujam Rushinam Satre. These Rishis whose name was Vishvasruja, Vishvasrut. These Rishis. Either Rishis who are creating the Vishwa also, you can say. Vishvasrujam Rushinam Satre. Either Vishvasrujam represent the name of the Rishis, the group of Rishis, or the Rishis who are creating this world. Satram Nama Yatra Rutvijaha Eva Yajmanaha Swayam Bhutva Vicharadi Kurvate. Satra is where the Rishis themselves assemble and perform. So, these yaga is performed not for someone else, but Rishis themselves assemble and perform the yaga. Not perform for some other yajmana. That's called Satra. So, in this kind of yajna means, this Vishvasrujam Rishinam Satra. So, Vishvasrut of the six case plural is Vishvasrujam. In this Satra, so only Rishis were there. So this Brahmadatta must be a Rishi who was saying this to other Rishis. Somam Bhakshayan Vacha. While he was Bhakshayan, eating means drinking the Soma, Brahmadatta said. Now continuing.
Kimayam Jamasastha Maya Vakshimanaha Raja Tyasya Tasya.
What is it? Tyasya?
Oh yeah, okay.
The Tuasya, that's what it is.
No, Tasya. Tyasya it means, I see. Tasya Mama Anutavadinaha Murdhanam Shiraha Vipatayata Vispashtam Patayatu Toho Ayam Tatangadeshaha Ashishilot Vipatayata Iti Yadi Aham Anurtavadisyam Ityarthaha.
Okay. So, Bhakshan Uvacha, he said, Kim, what did he say? I am means this one. So, he shows this Raja, Soma Raja. Chamasastha, Chamasastha Raja. This Raja who is in Chamasa, meaning in this Patra. So, in this cup that the Raja, Soma Raja is there. So, it's not that he had a big jug or something like that. Chamasastha, you know that, Prasada. So, Maya Bhakshamanaha. This Soma that I am drinking. This Raja, Tyasya, Tyasya means Tasya, Mama, anudavadinah murdhanam shira vipadayata. This Raja may chop off my head of me who is anudavadi. That is my, he may drop chop off my head, I who is a liar. Of me who is liar, may this Raja chop off the head. If I were the liar, of course. So, vipadayata vispastam padayatu, may he very clearly chop off my head if I am lying. So vipadayatu, it should be there, but it says vipadayatat, so tu has become tat. How? Tohoyam tatangadeshah. This tu become tat. Ashishi Lord, then there is a Ashir ling, you know. So vipadayatat iti vispashtam padayatu. He may very clearly chop off my head if I were. So yadi aham anudavadisyam. If I am telling a lie, or if I am a liar, then may the Somaraja drop off or chop off my head. So in those days, the only chopping of head, that will come several times in Rodhanyaka. So, then head drops off also. Your head will drop off and it drops off. The fellow is far wrong, the head drops off. But they had the ability to put it back, I'm sure, you know. And that is why. So this chopping of the head is not uncommon. It can be symbolic, or it can be perhaps something that really happened, but anyway. Anutavaditvasya prapagavad aprapti shangari katham punaha, says Vashya, continuing. How can such a one as Brahmadatta be anutavadi, you know? Katham punaha anutavaditva prapti iti uchare yata yadi itaha asmat prakrutat pranat vak sanyuta ayasya mukhya prana vidayakena ayasya angirasa shabdena abhidhiyate vishvasrajam purvarshinam satre udgata saha anyena devatantarena vak pranam vidriktena udgayata udganam krutvam tataha aham anutavadisyam katham punaha anutattva vadita prapya. How can someone like Brahmadatta be anutavadi? Says Anandagiri here, udganasya buddhyadi sannidhanat tad devata prajapatyadi rakshanam kim tasmin devata kimva varnaswarad sannidhanat tad devata eva tatra devata iti vipratipatte anudvaditve shankire brahmadatta shapadhena nirnayam chakara iti aha. Udganasya buddhyadi sannidhanat tad devata. Buddhyadi sannidhanat, footnote 4 on that page 136. Abuddehe udgana anutpattehe udganasya buddhyadi sannidhanam. Well, naturally one who doesn't have buddhi or the mind, he cannot sing. So we can say that the singer has necessarily a proximity of the buddhi. Adipadena vagadi grahyam, that when the chanting or singing of the Samaveda is, mind also is required, the speech also is required. Vagadi naam cha udgana sambandha tum na udgayati spashtah eva uktah. That Vag and all the Indriyas are connected to Udgana, that is already clearly, was clear from the earlier passages. Tvam na Udgayati, Devatas went to Vag Indriya, said, may you sing for us. Shows that all these Devatas are also associated with Udgana. That's why you have question. Whether it's Prana Devata or whether the other Devatas are evident. Prana Devata is not so evident. Therefore, the question is, who is the Devata who is really involved in this Udgana? Footnote number 6, footnote number 5. Prajapatyadi iti prajapati chaturmukaha तस्य अपत्यानि बृहस्पत्यालयः प्राजापत्याः बुद्धिदेवता बृहस्पति में भी बृहस्पति इज इन्वॉल्व्ड ही इज द देवता ऑफ दिस उद्गीत दैट क्वेश्चन में अराइज बिकॉज बुद्धि इज इन्वॉल्व्ड सो इन चैंडिंग ऑफ उद्गीत बुद्धि इज इन्वॉल्व्ड सो देवता ऑफ द बुद्धि बृहस्पति में भी द देवता विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दिस उद्गान और आदिना पदवाक्य स्थानानि कंठादित स्थानम और वाग इंद्रिय समुद्र देवता दर इन्वॉल्व सो दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस सो दैट्स व्हाई उद्गानस्य बुद्ध्यादि देवता से निदानात तद्देवता प्राजापत्यादि लक्षणा किम तस्मिन् देवता सो इन दिस उद्गानम इज बृहस्पति इज द देवता किम वा वर्ण स्वरादि से निदानात और वाग इंद्रिय वर्ण स्वर एटसेट्रा इज ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व इन द उद्गानम तद्देवता एव तत्र देवता यदि विप्रतिपत्ते है और इस वाग देवता इज देवता और बृहस्पति इज देवता और प्राण इज देवता विप्रतिपत्ते है सिक्स फुट नंबर सेवन ब्रह्मदत्तो उद्गातृके यज्ञे समागतानां ऋषीणां उद्गीत देवता निश्चय अभावात् ताम उद्देश्य उक्तरीत्या विप्रतिपत्ति आसीत् सो दिस ऋषिज मस्ट हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग दिस व्हेन ब्रह्मदत्ता मेड अ स्टेटमेंट लाइक दिस It must be in reference to the discussion that is going on among the Rishis because that's what they used to do. During the day they would perform this yaga. In the evening then they would sit down and have this. That's how the sabha used to be. The olden days in the Vedic times, the assemblies and the seminars that we have today used to be of that nature. That somebody would sponsor some Rishi, would perhaps invite other Rishis. And then they perform the yaga and things during the day. In the evening some of them would read this Puranas or Vedas. That's how Sutta and other Rishis were assembled. You know, all these Puranas are sung, sung that way. Or they would have these learned discussions among themselves. That's how they would exchange their views. And they would learn from each other and that is how the knowledge also would spread. So that must have been the method in the olden days. So it says here, Brahmadatta Udgatruke Yajne. Maybe there must be Yajna in it. Brahmadatta must be Udgatru. He must be the reciter here. Samagatanam Rushinam, all the other Rushis were also assembled there. Udgita Devata Nishchaya Bhavat. So other Devata, other Rushis were not very clear as to who the Udgita Devata was. Meaning who was the Devata who was responsible for this Udgita, primarily responsible. Tam Uddishya Uktaritya Vipratipatti Asi. With reference to them, that Devata, this kind of Vipratipatti or This kind of a question, the difference of opinion must have existed among the Rishis. Tataha prasparasmin anutavaditve tahi shankite. Therefore, if I think that the Udgita Devata is prana, then somebody says Brihaspati, I say you are wrong. Anutavadi means you are wrong. Somebody says Agni Devata, you are wrong. So paraspara anutatvavadite shankitehi shankite. So therefore, each one may think that the other person is wrong because they will not able to arrive at a consensus. तहि संकेते सति विद्वत् अग्रणी ब्रह्मदत्तः सो दिस ब्रह्मदत्त मीन्स विद्वत् अग्रणी ही मस्ट बी रियली द लीडर यू नो द ऑफ ऑल दिस लर्नड पीपल सो द मोस्ट लर्नड ब्रह्मदत्त उद्गाता सो देन ही टेक्स अ स्टेज यू नो ही टेक्स अ माइक्रोफोन लेट अस से ही इज उद्गाता सर्वैः आप्ततमत्वात् ऑल ऑफ देम आर आप्त ऑलरेडी ही इज आप्ततम ही इज द मोस्ट लर्नड मोस्ट वेल इन्फॉर्मड मोस्ट लर्नड अमंग देम Sakshikrutaha. So he must be the person who must step in and ask to give his opinion about this. Saha shapatat dvarena dvara ishta devata nirnam chakara ityataha. Then how did Brahmadatta express his opinion? Brahmadatta must have been asked to give his opinion because he was the most learned among those who were assembled. And how did Brahmadatta then express his opinion? So then he took a shapat. He took this pratignya. He said, wow, this is what would happen. So by God, something like that, and whatever that means. But then, this is how Brahmadatta also, by the Shapada, declared his ascertained opinion that Mukhya Prana is a Devata of this Udgita. So this is an interesting way, thank God that this explanation is given. This is how the Sabhas must be, this is how people must be also declaring their knowledge or opinion. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः
Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om
The Mantra 24 on the page 26 Thabe Brahmadattaschaikitaneyo Rajanam Bhakshayan Vacha Ayantyasya Raja Murdhanam Vipatayata Yaditaha Ayasya Angirasaha Anyena Udgayaditin Vacha Chasheva Saprana cha Udagai Diti Thus Brahmadattaha Chaikitaneyaha said he is Sarvehi Aptatamatvat Sakshikritaha. In a sutra where the Rishis have assembled to perform a yaga, and where these discussions pertaining to Brahma must have been going on, there this Brahmadatta, this Chaikitaneyaha, the great grandson of Chaikitana, he must have been looked upon by other people as the most learned person. He is Aptatamaha, so the most learned, and this is how perhaps he must have been the one upon whom this decision must have been left as to who is the deity or the devata for this the singing of this Udgita. And then he made this statement. Rajanam Bhakshan, while drinking this soma, that must be a pious act actually, otherwise, you know, it's not that he was drinking and saying this kind of thing. So idea is, drinking soma means that having completed these yagas, then taking prasada, that perhaps shows a certain state of mind. Vacha, ayam tyasya raja, Mudhanam Vipatayatat. This Soma Raja, may he chop off my head, this deity. Yet itaha ayasyangirasaha anyen udgayaditi. Ayasyangirasaha, this priest called ayasyangirasaha in a previous sutra. Itaha anen udgayaditi. If he chanted his udgita by a devata other than the prana devata, then may my head chop off. Meaning, then I would be a liar. Or out of the one whose knowledge is false. Cannot call him liar. Anutavadinaha mama. Anutavadi is not a liar as such. Not that he knows one thing and says something else. He is a liar in that sense. But his knowledge is false. That's all. His knowledge is not in keeping with the truth. So my knowledge would not be in keeping with truth. And therefore I would be, in that sense, defiling the truth. Then my head would chop off. A drop off. So this is Vastaha Shapatadvara Ishtadevata Nirnayam Chakara. This Shapata or Pratignya, this kind of vow he took in presence of everybody else. And that was just to assert his knowledge that Prana is the Devata of the Udgita and to let everybody know. And thus this is just to emphasize that Prana is the Devata. This emphasis is done here by this Akshayika. So we are reading the Anandagiri Tika on the page 136. Udganasya buddhyadi sannidhanat tad devata prajapatyadi lakshana kim tasmin devata. Thus, because when the chanting or reciting takes place, there are many faculties that are involved. Mind is one faculty that is involved, speech is another faculty that is involved. And so many faculties are involved, and therefore, which is the faculty that really accomplishes this recital in the primary sense? That would be the Devata, by whose anugraha this recital is possible. Who is that faculty? Is it the Devata of the Buddhi, namely Brihaspati, by whose grace this takes place? Or perhaps the Devata of the speech, which is Agni, is that the Devata?
Kimva Varnaswaradi Sandhidanat Tadevata.
Or in the recital, Varna is there, Swaras are there, so tone is there and the syllables are there. All of these are also involved in the recital. So perhaps the deity who brings that makes that possible, anyway, the deity of the speech, maybe that is the deity involved here.
Iti Vipratipattihi
Anudavaditve Shankide. Maybe the rishis might have been presenting different positions, and therefore each one may have been accusing the other as Anudavadi.
Brahmadatta Shapadena Nirnayam Chakara.
In that sabha then, Brahmadatta Nirnayam Chakara, he ultimately gave his Nirnaya or ascertained opinion in the form of this Shapatha, in the form of this vow.
So Uchadeiti.
Therefore the question was that here this Brahmadatta said, Yadi aham anudavadisyam ityardaha. So he said that my head may drop off if I am anudavadi, if I am a liar, let's say, or telling that which is not the truth.
Katham punah anudavaditva prapti.
How can he be lying? Nobody lies really. And still it's called anudavad in this sense alone. That if the deity really is not what he says, then he would be anudavad in that sense alone, it is said.
Deva Bhashyakara says, Uchyate.
Bhashya says, Uchyate
yata yadi itaha asmat prakrutat pranat vak sanyuktat ayasyah mukhya prana abhidayakena ayasya angirasa shabdena abhidiyate vishvasrujam purvarshinam satre udgata saha anyena devatantarena Vak prana vyatiriktena udagayata udganam krutavan tataha aham anurdavadisyam tasya mama devata viparita pratipattuhu Murdhanam vipatayatu ityevam shapatham chakara iti vijnane pratyadardhya kartavyatam darshayati.
Uchyate, so it is said how he can be said to be anudavadi. Uchyate yad means yadi. Itaha, in the fifth case, itaha means asmad, prakrutat, pranat, vak sanyutat. If this ayasya angirasaha, this name, the priest, is also ayasya angirasa. Actually, we were told that in the earlier passage, in the eighth mantra here, that the mukhya prana is ayasya, asya bhavaha, and then angirasaha, anganam rasaha. Therefore, mukhya prana really is so called. But even a priest also is so called. Earlier, a priest who must have recited this Udgita in that satra, he was also called Ayasya Angirasa only on account of his total identification with this prana. So that's what Bhashyakara explained. Ayasya Mukhya Prana Abhidayakena Ayasya Angirasa Shabdena Abhidhiyate Vishvasrujam Purvashinam Satre Udgata. Udgata abhidhyate. This Udgata, or the one who recited this Sama Mantra, is so called Mukhya Prana Abhidayakena, whose name also is the same as that of Mukhya Prana. Ayasya Angirasa Shabdena. So he also is called Ayasya Angirasa. Vishvasrujam, meaning Etan Namakanam Purvashinam Satre Udgata. So the Udgata of the chanter in the Satra, all the rishis whose name was Vishvasruj, all these rishis were there. So in that Satra, this Udgata was so named Ayasya Angirasa. So Brahmadatta says, in that Yasatra of the Vishvasrut rishis, the Ayasya Angirasa who performed the recital, if he performed a recital with the help of a deity other than the prana, then my head would drop off. Meaning when Ayasya Angirasa performed the recital, he was able to do it only by the blessing of the grace of this deity which is prana, so along with the Vagdevata. So asmat, prakrutat, pranat, vak, sanyuktat. Prana is this, that is why it was said, that vak is upasarjana or the secondary, or the supporting function. Prana has a primary function and vak has a supporting function in which saha anyena devatantarena vak prana vitriktena udagayata. So udgata yaha bahuva. This udgata who happened at that time, saha anyena devatantarena vak prana vitriktena udagayata. If he performed this udganam by a devata other than vak prana, where the vak is upasarjana, vak the secondary, the prana the primary, that devata, meaning prana devata, udganam kratuvan tataha, says footnote number 3, udgita devatatvena madabhimada pranat anyena devatantarena ayasya kartruko udganat ityarthaha. Meaning, if this ayasya angirasa priest perform the recital of udgita by devata other than the prana which I am talking about, tataha then aham anutavadi syam, then I would call anutavadi, one who speaks falsely. Tasya mama, of me who is such, meaning anutavadi, devata viparita pratipattuhu, who knows the devata in a wrong way. So pratipattuhu, one who knows the devata viparitatvena. So one who knows the devata wrongly or knows the wrong devata is right. Mudanam vipadayatu. This raja, this soma raja, may he chop off my head who is thus telling a lie. Meaning, who is thus presenting a devata in the light which is wrong or different from what it is. Idevam shapatham chakara. This kind of shapata of the vow, this brahmadatta took in this sabha. Iti, what for? Vijnane pratyadardhya kartavidam darshayati. In this manner, the Shruti shows Vijnane, in the Prana Vijnanam, that Prana is the Mukhya Devata, in that Pratyadardhyatam. So, Pratyadardhya Kartavyatam, that one must have a Dardhya Drudata, or the firmness of that conviction. In short, this Upasana or meditation on Prana requires a firmness of the conviction that Prana is the principal deity. And any Upasana is going to require that. When that Pratyaya or the firmness is not there, we are not able to focus our mind, you wonder. Swamiji, I have been chanting all the time, Om Namah Shivaya, and now when I go to Rama temple, you know, then I wonder. Or in my puja room, there is Shiva also, and then Rama also, and Krishna also, and then sometimes I chant this mantra, sometimes I do that. Everybody does everything, you know. Sometimes you wonder that some devata may get displeased, or which is the principal devata, I do not know, and then so much confusion happens in our mind. So when that conviction about one devata is not there in our mind, when our heart also is not associated with that, then how difficult it becomes for us to focus our attention. So meditation requires a flow of constant flow of the thoughts. And that is possible only when the interruption is not there. And there are many interruptions possible, raga, dvesha, and many other things can bring out interruptions. But one principal thing that can bring about interruption in my flow of thought is my lack of conviction or lack of firmness of conviction. Yeah, but how about Hanumanji? How about Shivji, you know? Shivji, they say Shivji is such and such, you know? Looks like he is greater than Vishnu. And then I read some Devi Purana, then looks like that he is the greatest, you know? And that is how, as you keep on reading different Puranas and different Kathas and things, you know, this mind really gets confused. So you wonder, who is the principal Devata? And so, and that conviction is not there. That's why I keep changing every 6 months, you know. Now I am doing Shiva Puja and then then Lala and then Rama, and then they keep changing, you know, because whatever it is. Or some people believe that that's what should happen. Ultimately, you should wind up with Shiva, then that is a real upasana. Some people believe ultimately you should wind up with Krishna, you know. Then, so whatever beliefs are there, but then when there is a lack of conviction about one devata, it does create a difficulty in our focusing attention. That's a fact. So, pratyedardhya kartavyadam darshayati, there should be no doubt whatever that prana is the principal deity which is responsible for the recital of Udgita. Uktartha dardhyaya iti uktam upasamharate. Uktamin iti vakyena pratignyadam akhyayikartham ityartha. Vashyakara said, even in the page 135 in the last sentence, Uktartha dardhyaya akhyayika arabhyade. That's what Vashyakara had said. Upasamharati, that Vashyakara concluded. That is the purpose of this akhyayika. Says Anandagiri, Uktaritya shapatha kriyaya prana eva udgita devata. Yasmin vijnane pratyaya vishvasaha. So uktaritya meaning shapatha kriyaya. By this shapatha kriya. Prana eva udgita devata. That prana alone is the udgita devata. Idhyasmin vijnane, in this knowledge, meaning in this meditation. Pratyaya vishvasaha, in this knowledge there must be pratyaya means vishvasa, a conviction. Tasya dardhyam, that firmness of that conviction. Tasya kartavyatam, that there is kartavya, that one must have the firmness of this conviction that prana is the deity of the udgita. Akhyayikaya darshayati shruti yavada. Shruti wants to say this. Shruti has different ways of saying things. Akhyayika. So, arthavada is a way of saying it, and that is a method that is employed here.